we noticed that in a few cases at the beginning there was some positive words were used, but at the end, I mean, some other with a negative meaning were used. So we were intrigued in understanding, investigating if a certain sequence of a positive, negative, and so on and so forth would help in the detection of a wrong opinion. And maybe also as a last set of patterns we consider, as I said, not only the pleasantness aspect of the whistle dictionary, but also activation, that is the degree of response that one from a cognitive point of view following what these psycholinguistic write-downs in terms of number between 1 and 3, we could have listening or reading, in this case, the word, and they measure it. So some words are more difficult to imagine than others. Flower, okay, we immediately can see a flower there, good. I mean, we have some more difficulties, so a lower score is given. We carry out this experiment using the information, the tags, the hashtags that the user use with, in Twitter. So consider the tweets targeted with the irony hashtag, but some other tags as well, like education, humor, politics. And we carry out some experiments considering these four sets of linguistic-based patterns, considering two distribution balance, the same number of ironic sample and not ironic text in what tweets in this case, and in balance, more not ironic. And also here, I mean, we were, of course, we didn't have the magic feature, but we were able to obtain the decent results in the case of the especially in the case of the balanced scenario that is less realistic, but we were able to obtain a good improvement with respect to the case. But also, even with a less amount of a percentage of improvement in the case of the balance. And skip that for the delay. And just to give the flavor of the usefulness of this kind of task from an information retrieval point of view, as I said, it would be interesting to retrieve when at the time of retrieving some text to be aware if they are humorous or not. And so we carry out some experiments of the binary classification on the basis of the four tasks using black dot, so funny versus informative text, funny versus insightful, funny versus negative, and with a couple of classifiers, is decision tree, and well, accuracy was nearly 50% in some of the cases. Last, of the Toyota case, so the importance of the online reputation for enterprises. We've seen at the beginning the case of the Toyota. It's interesting for them to know, I mean, actually, the amount of irony that they could be in the tweets about the enterprise. In this case, the hashtag was the Toyota, so we couldn't rely on the hashtag on the background of the crowd. Out in a third of the irony. So of course we had some manual annotation, and depending on the threshold that we use in order to take as ironic as certain tweet or not, we had a different result. And as you can see, actually, if the threshold is very high, at the end the F measure is 50%. So this in order to make you understand that the task is difficult and these are preliminary results not able to be done, but has been a good fun, and in some of the cases the results were decent, and we hope for someone else that would be also interested in this process. Just to sum up in a couple of words, our aim was to start approaching the figurative language processing. There are different kinds of figurative language devices, recent metaphor, we didn't approach it, but we will work a lot in Ireland on this topic. So we approach human recognition and especially error detection in the opinion. And there isn't the magic feature, as we have seen. In some cases, some features seem to work decently, but as also noticed, it depends very much on the kind of text of the social medium we are dealing with. And so the most difficult case when all the difficulties joined together, short text, very noisy formal way of writing, and so on, is certainly Twitter, where we try to come up with a more high-level, ambitious a set of features. Preliminary results are decent, but we have seen also some practical examples, like the online recommendation classification task, in which results are, if we are very demanding with respect to the threshold, the agreement between annotators and results can be still quite poor. Thank you very much. In case you like the topic, you can find some stuff that we have recently published, and please, you are more than welcome to give a critics also later by talking. Thank you.
Questions?
Any
questions? Thank you for the presentation, Paolo. So I just want to know, what is the difference between sarcasm detection and error detection, and what are the challenges in error detection? Because I guess it's a bit different.
Yes, I mean, at the time of starting working on a few years ago, we were working with a PhD student of mine on word sensitive language, and we had the pleasure to have Adam Yalcea as a keynote speaker in a workshop that we organized, and at the time she was working on human recognition, and even if not exploiting too much the ambiguity in recognizing the pattern and recognizing humor aspects. So, I mean, we were sort of inspired by her, so we started, instead of this ambiguous chunk of text to see if they were used the way they were used in order to provoke it in funny effect. So we started from there working on the humorous But then we realized that in some cases the funny effect is produced by irony. And only in some cases, and actually was very much difficult to recognize these cases. So we focus on the last years on irony detection, and we were very much interested in detecting ironic comments in social media. So this has been the shift, just to give you the overall picture. And we realized that it's much more difficult than humor recognition. This is what you ask.
Yeah. I was asking, like, how is it different from the sarcasm detection? Because sarcasm detection is
like... Yes, as I said, I mean... Okay. you made the question and you answer. No, in the sense that for instance, I show you at the beginning some example. If you find it hard to laugh at yourself, I would be happy to do it for you. Do you consider ironic, sarcastic? Ironic. I guess if we both, some could consider it as sarcastic. Of course, it depends on, first of all, not even linguists agree on the distinction between irony and sarcasm. But certainly, having to work just with the text, we don't have the multimodal information like the pitch of the voice or the way I tell you. If I tell you, you will find it harder at yourself, to laugh at yourself, I would be happy to do it for you. Maybe just because of the tone, I can consider more sarcastic, more punchy, and less subtle. So we decided to consider it as overall. And actually, there are words that name it a sarcasm, but they have the same approach. I mean, they don't make a distinction between a sarcasm and irony, because it's not really clear, and having to work with a verbal text, so with text, verbal irony, it's, I think there would be two issues. The results are still decent, but preliminary, so be too much.
I was wondering about the application in from some say for example information access point of view. Maybe for and you in a better position to comment on this. For example, there are measures like fog index to measure the readability of a text, given text. Now, do you think that this irony detection or these things is a kind of measure that can help us to understand how complex the piece of text is? Or can that be a component to measure the readability of a text? Or and there must be some culture dependency. And
yes, you're right. And actually, we employed this readability. I mean, the measures the Gandhi Power Index, flash and so on and so forth. For another more related, probably task like this. Plagiarism detection of the plagiarized text, because especially when you are not able to find the original source of the document, you have to rely on the information of the text itself. But even if in this case, it happens what sometimes it happens to us when we read a report, okay, pretty poor. Poorly written paragraph, and then immediately, like if the person has been inspired, and the style was very formal, and so on. So this could be applying different tasks. We didn't do it here, and actually, we could have done, or we could do in the future. We try to, for instance, to take into consideration this. This idea that some of the example could be just in order to provoke this effect, it could be more difficult because they have to play with words, so they have to change the order of words, maybe to give a different meaning. And we try to cover this aspect considering the lexical complexity, with an approach by some sort in Italy, which considers, takes into account the number of clauses, the nominal clauses, the verbal clauses, and so on and so forth. But this is another way possibly to.
And just another thing, I saw that you were mentioning British National Corpus, and you collected these irony things from.
No, irony is not in the British National Corpus, of course. They are texted pretty formal. What I wanted to say, but I realized that I wasn't clear enough, that the aim was for instance, words, quite likely words like "fidos" and so on, because they come from a formal text. The informal, possibly ironic way to employ another word like "days," so something that is not expected, so the probability is very low, so the perplexity is high, and potentially, I don't know, this information plus some other information, as I say, that there isn't a magic feature, all together could help some clue that this could be a figurative language use of.
Can you refer some statistics that what percentage of these kind of things are there in informative text, like say news documents or maybe from the literature?
Statistic of the humorous,
5% or something like
that. We didn't carry out this experience. I was actually asked recently a similar question, and we didn't carry out the amount of humor that is in use, the amount of irony is in use, and first of all, because it would be a matter to tag this before, and was a problem in the problem, so in order to have some preliminary result, but to be able to move a little bit forward, we decided to rely on the tags that the user decided, and majority of users decided that certain reviews were ironic. Okay, let's believe that. But yeah, it would be interesting.
Any other questions?
Thank you.
So then, Paolo?